Excuse me, sir. You work here?
No, I just hang around here for fun. Joking, I'm joking. How can I help you, friend?
I know this sounds crazy. Some dumb old coot I know is telling me there's these houses you can buy pre-cut.
Not crazy, friend. The very latest in modern convenience. Convenient and cost-efficient. Which house do you want? Each one is entirely unique, but also the same.
Excuse me?
Perhaps I'm going too fast, sir. Do you want to buy a house?
I think so.
I'll give you a luxurious, entirely unique pre-cut palace. And if you order today, I guarantee your home in a matter of weeks, maybe sooner.
I'll take that one.
Ah, yes, we have that one in stock.
And I already got credit from the bank.
Oh, fantastic. Now, you write your name here, and you sign your name there, and you will be the proud owner of a factory-built home.
It's that easy.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Martin. Albert Cakes, Esquire, at your service.
You boys give me a minute.
What are you doing here? Everything okay?
I'm not sure. Probably. A fella came by the farm. Got attacked on the road. He said the Skinner brothers was hanging around. Lots of them. Left Uncle armed to the teeth back at the ranch.
Who are these two?
Guns for hire. This Skinner's about, we need him.
We ain't got that kind of money, Charles.
You want to get robbed for your house?
No, but...
Hey, these Skinners can be nasty. Come on. Mr. Devon, you're with me. Mr. Wayne, this is...
Milton. Jim Milton.
Sir, good to meet you.
We're going to be heading up to the Manzanita Post.
Why?
The best smith around is that Norwegian fella up there.
So they say. You boys ready?
Yes, sir, we're ready.
Good, because you're about to get shot at over a goddamn hammer.
You want to build a house with a sniper rifle, then?
I know old Niels real well. I'll get you a good deal.
Thank you, sir. All right, then. Let's go buy us some tools.
I know the quickest way. Follow me.
Say... Is your friend a Negro or a Redskin?
I think a bit of both, for what it's worth.
Cash is cash. Though it's all the same to me. I saw you getting skittish there, but don't you worry. We're not getting shot at.
Oh, yeah. I know Charles Smith. If he's got cause to be concerned, it's usually good cause.
You got a shotgun messenger sitting right beside you, all right? Now, suppose you don't know much about robbing caravans.
Not much, I guess. No.
Well, nor do I. But I know a thing or two about protecting them. And if a robber sees some strong men sitting up front, two of them guns behind, then they're gonna wait for the next set of fools to come on through.
Unless they take the guns to mean they're carrying something valuable. Instead of pre-cut timber and some tools.
What? No. Wait, look. Trust me on this. You are overthinking it. You hire a gun, you hire peace of mind and a deterrent. So I'll sit here looking big and scary, and you can concentrate on the horses.
All right. I'll do just that.
Maybe I've done this kind of thing before, and maybe I can handle a weapon. But I'm not so different from you, partner.
I think you might be.
People wonder how you can handle it. Living by your gun. But it's the same as any other occupation, really.
Hey! We're taking the next right up towards Manzanita Post.
What were you saying?
When I get home, I put my gun on the rack and it stays there. I mean it. It really stays there. I don't even think about it. My mind's on my wife and the little ones. I'm chopping wood, mending the roof, putting the kids to bed. But when I'm out here, I'm watching the tree line. I got my gun at the ready. And I'm trying to make my employer as comfortable as possible.
That's, real good of you.
You're in good hands. I know this country well.
Good. Am I finally gonna meet this tool maker?
Now, Niels, He's an acquired taste, but boy, can he work metal. Norwegian, you see? Viking blood. Fellas up there used to worship a god with a hammer. Guess I figures they'd still be making them. I'm not sure how much English he speaks, but Niels knows tools.
This is the spot, just up ahead.
Okay.
You boys wait here. After you, Mr. Milton.
Go speak to the man. Buy your tools, John. I want to get out of here.
Like I said, Nils is an acquired taste. Let me do the talking.
There he is, working away.
Nils.
Nils, it's me. Willard Wayne.
Okay.
This is my associate, Jim Milton.
Okay.
He heard you was the best. Best smith around. He needs some tools. He's building a ranch house up at Beecher's Hope.
Beecher's Hope? Okay.
Have you got any made?
Okay.
Like I said, an acquired taste, but a heart of gold, and he's the best. You off someplace, Nils?
Okay.
So Milton is working with Cakes Hardwood and Timber in town. Should I get them to pay you and add it to his bill up there?
Okay.
Come on, let's get moving.
Okay.
All right then, Beecher's Hope. They've been trying to sell that property for some time, hadn't they? Took a look at it myself, as it so happens. Seemed like a lot of work. Too much for me, but more power to you. Must have seen something in it I couldn't. World needs.
Whoa! Everyone find some cover! Goddamn! Keep your head down! Where'd they come from?
Devin, you okay?
Yes.
Is that the last of them?
I think so.
There's more! They got the tools!
They grabbed Mr. Wayne!
All right, you stay here, guard the wagon. Charles, come on!
Thank you. cuffed, you bastard!
These woods are ours! Four! We've come the right way! The bushes! They're coming at us!
Tools. Now, where's Mr. Shit. Jesus. We gotta move fast. Come on.
Let's go. Back to the road.
Minutes ago, he was chewing my ear off.
He knew what he was getting into.
Did he?
Skinners. Everyone knows.
Except me.
Later, John.
Charles, you all right carrying him?
I got it. There's no use in you getting bloody, too.
Is it bad?
They opened him up pretty good. Nearly chopped his head in two.
God damn them.
Mr. Wayne didn't make it.
Dear Lord, no.
We have to get out of here. You take him in the back wagon. Come on, help me.
All right, let's get out of here.
Oh, my Lord. What'd they do to him?
Nothing nice.
Got it. Come on. We gotta go. Shit. Those goddamn animals.
Okay. John, I'm riding with you. Get us back to Beaches.
Those were the Skinner brothers.
I told you I was worried.
Sadie said something, too. What kind of land have I bought?
It's not the land. The Skinners move around. But they're here for now.
I thought this kind of bloodshed was meant to be over with. What was all the nonsense about civilization?
This kind of bloodshed is different. Folks have been killed, sure. For good reason and bad. But rarely just for the fun of it.
That was fun for them?
No. Not that time. Most folk don't usually put up with such a fight.
Then I hope we put an end to it.
There was a caravan. A few months back, massacred. Men, women, children. Ended up like Wayne. Or worse.
Damn. Uncle! Useless sack of crap.
I was keeping guard.
Really?
Whoa. What happened?
Skinner brothers.
A lot of them?
Enough. Once this is done, I'll take Mr. Devon back to town
Yeah, poor Mr. Wayne buried.
Okay. Be careful.
Well, I will. But I'm fairly sure we scared him off for now.
Bad business. Well, we'll be safe together.
Sure. If you say so.
And John, I love you. Don't you forget that.
Those plans make any sense?
Oh, sure.
Seems easy enough, I think.
How hard can it be? But I'll tell you what I think, just to be safe.
I'll do the reading and planning, and you do the building.
How did I know you'd try to weasel out of doing any work?
Oh, now, that is plain unfair. It's inaccurate and not what's going to happen. I'm simply going to use what I've got, which is a brain. Or you use what you've got, which is less of a brain.
Let's get started.
Well, first thing it says the foundation, which involves moving those heavy wooden joists. Definitely not a job for a man with terminal lumbago unless you want to dig a 6-foot-deep hole for me when the work day's over.
Don't tempt me.
Oh, well, here comes Charles. Maybe he can lighten the mood a little.
How'd you get on?
He'll be back, but not for a while.
Charles, dear boy, John needs help moving these joists. Now, come on. Get a move on. We gotta get started before the rains come.
You're very annoying.
He's right. We should get on with this.
Cut it. I'll climb up a ladder with a hammer and a nail, now nail it. Well, we worked so hard to build a little house together. In the snow or the rain or the ice cold wind, whenever. No matter what the weather, we're together. me have a rule and a saw and a board and I'll cut. Climb up a ladder with a hammer and a nail and I'll nail it. Well, we worked so hard to build a little house together. In the snow or the rain or the ice cold wind, whenever. No matter any weather, we're together.
I think that's everything.
John Marston, you have a home.
So do you.
Oh, I know.
And you, Charles, as long as you'll stay with us.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, to this happy home. At least till this fool gets his woman back.
My darling Abigail, I hope you and Jack are doing well. I remain a fool, and I'm sure I shall die a fool. But I'm trying very hard to be something like the man you deserve. I have done something very silly in an effort to impress you. And that is, I've purchased a home. The land you read about in the newspaper up at Beecher's Hope is now ours, and we are going to try our hand at ranching. Mr. Geddes kindly helped me buy the land. I met Uncle while I was coming out of the bank, and while I know your feelings about him, he has been enormously helpful in his own fashion. Charles Smith has also appeared and is unsurprisingly a pillar of strength. Together, we've built you a home. I hope soon to show it to you. I miss you and the boy more than I can express. Please, come back to me. Yours always, John. Uncle, I thought you was... Where the hell? I'm back, girl. Mister?
How about you get out of my sight?
Down you get!
Cut it out, goddammit!
Yeah!
Time for this
light and the love. Hey, here. Easy there. Come on, lady. Is that all? Girl. You're all right, ain't you? Who are you, miss?
Morning.
Hey, good looking horse there. I'm all out of space. That'll make your horse happy. Best to have a good saddle that'll hold up. I have chores to attend to, so let's get this over with.
I have chores to attend to, so let's get this over with. That's a nice addition on a saddle.
Hola. The laziness just rubs me the wrong way.
Adding on to a saddle helps personalize it. I got one of them myself. Always good to have one of those. I have chores to attend to, so let's get this over with. Have a nice time.
Well done, boy.
Mr. Abel's thugs been wanting us to sign our land over. Only this time I escaped, but they have my husband. They're gonna kill him.
Abel's thugs, huh? Where are they?
It's the stone farmhouse back there where I came from.
I'll head there now.
I'll see about finding more help.
He
time this over, I'm gonna take a long time on you.
Just do it. We're gonna do it.
You see, we're used to a mite more cooperation than you're offering.
Y'all, Larry, all boys. Hell? I don't much like
it. Oh, you're real dumb.
Now get up! Get up! Hey, untie me, will you?
Still breathing, fella?
Get these damn ropes off me! Oh, yes. Thank you. Thank you. Those goddamn bastards deserve that and more. My wife. You seen my wife by any chance?
Yeah, I saw her. West of here. She told me to come find you.
Oh, thank God. But thank you for hearing her call. Where are you, my dearest? drinking?
I don't win soon, your wife's gonna kill
me. Oh, hello. Been a while. What do you have?
Hello. Hello? You looking for a haircut?
Hello there.
Hello.
Great. Thanks.
Hey there, feller. You see, they hanged that woman that's been killing Johns around the state. Well, she posed as a paid woman, took men up, sliced them up and into ribbons. Happy to say that those types of women have nothing to do with this establishment. Yes, sir.
I need some food. Can I get a meal?
Okay.
Ready, boy?
Hey, partner.
mister.
Hello?
Long time no see, John. Have a look around. Let me know if you need something.
Yeah, let me see.
Some kind of end of days coming. This government's one of the signs.
Okay. Enjoy. Yep. Yep. Sure, you seem to like it. Another. Okay. More. All right.
Tina found herself a necklace in Jim's pocket the other day. Ruby?
Great. That's all fixed then. Thanks, mister. Hey, I need to get to that poster behind you. Would you move a little?
I will not. Deputy put up plenty. Go get one of those.
Hey, move! I need that poster.
Oh, I'll move, all right. How's this for moving?
You cocksucking bastard!
You gonna do it then?
Come on, move already!
Boy,
of that. Calm down, boy. Let it out, boy.
Thank you. you now!
Easy there. You see anything we should be worried about?
Skinners? No. Seems quiet.
Good. Maybe that was all of them. Good boy. Nice work, fella. Boy. Did well, boy.
Hi there. Come on in. So what'll it be today?
That's a bit smarter. That looks better.
All right. You're ready to go.
Okay, boy. Thank you. Blow it! Is that all? Just one time I hope to find you working. Just once.
Do you believe in reincarnation, John Marston?
No.
Well, I hope and pray to whatever is out there that I get to come back as a youngin', so that when you're old and facing death, I can be some two-penny slave driver that comes along and hastens your journey into the grave. This is a fatal condition I got.
And I'll get...